I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created spirit to be. This is the most important assertion according to Jesus. And I've been saying that over and over and over and over again today and continuing this intense push. And it feels very intense. And it's stressful. It's sort of like something deep is happening, and it is stressful. There's no question about it. And yet, instead of collapsing, we continue. And in continuing, we are going to emphasize that I don't need a body, okay? I don't need a body. The body is actually utilized. We're trying to convince arrogance that it's not arrogant. And the body is utilizing that. That's the only reason we have a body. It's the world, only reason why we have a world. The world, the body, we are trying to convince arrogance that it's not arrogant. And by arrogance, I mean spiritual arrogance. Spirit, Son of God, which is what we are, is trying to convince arrogance, which is the idea that it can change reality. Spirit's idea that it can change reality. Trying to convince arrogance that it's not arrogant. In other words, and how do you do that? Well, that means we're trying to convince arrogance that it can accomplish. Reality can be changed. Okay, and then we say, look at the body. You see, look, let's see, the spirit's no longer spirit. It's the body. You know, and look at the world. Freedom is no longer freedom. It's now this time, space, process, and form, imprisonment location. And we say to arrogance, you see, you're not arrogant. You're telling the truth, arrogance. So, but we don't need a body. We don't need a world because it's impossible to convince arrogance that it is not arrogant, because we cannot change reality. Okay, so the belief that we can change reality is arrogant, sheer arrogance, always will be. So we keep trying to say to arrogance, oh, no, you're not arrogant, you're the new God, you know, and here, look at what you've done, and it still feels that arrogant, still says it's still arrogant because it hasn't changed reality really at all. So this is the root of saying I don't need a body. I don't need to be a body. The body is only used. We're only using it to try and convince arrogance that it's not arrogant. That's the tool we use. And when we say I don't need to do that because it's impossible, what do we need a body for? We can use a body as a communication device just to let people know it's impossible to convince arrogance that it's not arrogant, but that would be the only use left for the body, is just a communication device to explain to everyone that we don't need a body. So really the only use of the body is as a communication device to reassure everyone that we don't really need a body at all. We don't really need a world at all. We don't even need a universe at all. So we let this sink in, full stop in the wow. It's just like, ah. And it's not easy. Hearing this, if you say, saying the practice that we're doing, like, I don't know anything. I don't have any plans whatsoever. I don't have any plans whatsoever. It's like the death of the ego. You know, it's the death of our attempt to convince arrogance that it's not arrogant. This is what you call the ego, is really just all our attempts to convince arrogance that it's not arrogant. That's all the ego. So it's like this, like the death of the ego, because all our plans, all our schemes, everything we think we've learned, we've done, you know, all the progress we've made. You say, no, I haven't made it. I've never made any progress at all. I've never succeeded at all. I don't have any results whatsoever. You know, this is the death of the ego. And so practicing the death of the ego, the evaporation, I would say, actually, of the continuity fear. It's evaporating the continuity fear, but some people call it the death of the ego. We can practice that, actually. And it is stressful. It's not really painful, but it is stressful. It's sort of a deep sort of ache that you just like, feel like, oh, wow, this is really, something really heavy is taking place here. Well, that's okay. You can still function. Just get some rest. I don't have any solution whatsoever. Okay, when we say that, it means I don't know any way at all that I can convince or anyone can convince, that we can convince arrogance that it's not arrogant. I don't know any way whatsoever. I don't have any answers at all. I have no solution whatsoever. I don't have any strategy. I don't have any plan. I don't have any success. I don't have any results. I don't have any attainment. I don't have any achievement. I have no answers whatsoever. This hits real hard. It still hits hard. Even though I've been practicing it for a while, it hits hard. Because this is the opposite of the ego, isn't it? We're so used to the ego being our source of motivation. We think it's our life, because this is what gives us purpose, we think. And now we can say, I don't have any purpose whatsoever. I don't have any purpose whatsoever. It's sort of intentionally letting go of self-esteem, which is really egoic momentum and motivation and belief. And we have to do this. We have to recognize that there isn't any way to convince arrogance that it's not arrogant. We can't change arrogance. We cannot. It is arrogant. So, no matter how many universes we imagine, we will never be able to convince arrogance that it's not arrogant. Completely futile. Completely futile. Completely useless. Completely meaningless. Completely aimless. The great thing about this practice is it blocks out everything else. You realize nothing else is really important anymore in terms of spiritual practice. When you do this, you feel like, wow, this is it. I don't need to do anything else. There's nothing I can do. You see, there's absolutely nothing that I can do. I can't achieve anything. I cannot achieve anything whatsoever. Of course, because all achievement is entirely based on trying to convince arrogance. It's not arrogant. In reality, there's no such thing as achievement. It's just absolute freedom. There's no such thing as attainment, recognition, enlightenment, success, progress, results, answers, plans. None of that exists at all. None of it exists. It's all wrapped up for us in trying to convince arrogance it's not arrogant. So I don't need a body. I don't need a body. I don't need a flesh body at all. I can have a body of light. I don't need this world at all. Don't need this world at all. I have absolutely no use for this world. I have absolutely no use for this body. They have no use for time, space, process, or form whatsoever. These are just a dream I've imagined, trying to convince arrogance that it's not arrogant. Saying, "Hey, look at this dream. You know, this should convince you." It doesn't. It doesn't do anything. And we could dig into the theory behind this, which we have many times, but it's more important to practice at this point. More important to feel the burn, feel the wow of this. I don't know anything. I simply do not know. I do not know. I do not know. Because there isn't any way. I don't know. There isn't anything to know. There isn't any way. I don't know the way. See, I don't know the way. Why? Because there is no way. How can we know the way when there is no way to convince arrogance that's not arrogant? There isn't any way, so I don't know the way. I don't know the way. I don't know how to do it. There isn't any answer. I have no answers. I have no order. I have no clarity, right? How can we be clear about what can't be done? What is there to be clear about? I have no clarity. I have no success. There's nothing for me here. There's no value in the world whatsoever. There's absolutely nothing for me here. Nothing to find. There's absolutely nothing to find. That's a powerful one. I haven't tried that yet. Very powerful. There's absolutely nothing to find. So, while others may be floundering, we have a practice. We have a practice. And it's hard. But that's what we want. That's what we want. It's very compelling. There's absolutely nothing to find. I cannot find anything whatsoever. There's nothing to find. I don't need the world at all. I don't need bodies at all. I don't need worlds. I don't need bodies. I don't need time, space. I don't need process. I don't need form. There's no need for it. I don't have any needs. I don't need to convince arrogance that it's not arrogant. Not at all. I can just set down the desire to try to be greater than God. It's that simple. So, there's nothing to find. We're trying to find a way. There is no way. There is no way, and there's nothing to find. There is no way. Yes, I already know that there is no way, and that there is nothing to find. So this is evaporating a vast amount of ancient patterns of hope and belief and striving, etc. There is no way, and there's nothing to find. I don't have anything. There's nothing that I want, and I don't have anything. I'm completely empty. So we're emptying out all of this belief that we can find a way. All right, and leaving ourselves empty in this endeavor entirely. And then when this emptiness, that's then the dawning of the kingdom of now can commence. I'm absolutely empty. I don't have anything. Great thing about this practice, that you don't need any other words, really. This is enough. I'm absolutely empty. I don't have anything. There's nothing that I want. There's nothing that I value. And so we don't have to waste time digging through endless spiritual teachings, which just, they go on and on and on and on and on. Words, 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 words. Get right to the practice. I'm absolutely empty. I don't have anything. And feel the burn of that. Feel the wow of that. And you're doing the most intense practice possible. Don't have to be searching somewhere else and floundering around. Just, I don't know anything. I don't know anything. I don't want to get bit by mosquitoes either out here. I don't know anything. I don't know anything. I'm empty. There's nothing here that I want. There's nothing that I want. I'm not looking for anything. There's nothing that I can find. There is no way. There is no way, and there's nothing that I can find. Now, absorbing this and getting used to it is necessary because of the changes in society and what's going on in the world. Desperate attempts to claim that they found a way. You know, desperate optimism. But we're not in despair. We embrace despair in a positive way, saying, I can't find, there's nothing to find. There is no way. I'm empty. So we sort of co-opt the despair. We're not caught up in desperate optimism regarding trying to, we can find some way to convince arrogance. It's not arrogant. We're not caught up in that. And that's great, because getting caught up in that, wow, the wheels come off. It all becomes too weird, that is for sure. It's already too weird. So we can take refuge in practice. Easy. I'm empty. I don't have anything. There's nothing to find. There isn't any way. I don't have any answers. I don't have any success. I've never gotten anywhere. I've never achieved anything. Just I am. I am, full stop, in the now. I am released in the now. I am released in the now. No body, no world, no universe. Don't need any of them. Simply don't need them. This is how we set our illusions down, is realizing we simply don't need them. We don't make them real and then defeat them. We just realize, oh, they're completely unreal. I don't need them. I don't need them. I don't need to convince arrogance that it's not arrogant. Don't need to. And just accept, yeah, arrogance will always be arrogance. That's all it is. It's nothing. That's all it is. It can't change reality. So just we'll exchange it for the grace of God, which is preparation to realize that we don't need to prepare for the kingdom of time, for the rule of arrogance. I'm not a body, I'm free. I'm still spirit exactly as God created me to be. I don't need a body. I'm free. I don't need a body. I'm free. I don't need a body. I'm free. The value of bodies is because we keep thinking that if we can just convince arrogance it's not arrogant, then we can be the creators of God. See, creators of this new god, Arrogance. And so we're all thinking, wow, bodies are really very helpful, very necessary. The world, oh yeah, very useful. There's no use at all. The world is useless. Bodies are useless. We can say another affirmation we can make is, I am useless. I am completely useless. This refers to the ego. See, I am completely useless. Completely useless. I can never succeed. I am completely useless. I can never succeed. But we're saying it in a positive, like, yes, this is great to say this. We're basically saying the ego is, you know, you're completely useless. I am completely useless. And what we're doing is we're enabling the I am to just stand on its own instead of in relation to the ego. In the ego's objectives and goals. The I am doesn't have to prove anything, or do anything, or feel useful, or anything like that. Not at all. It's absolutely free. So, but we're so used to believing that it has to attain something, we have to keep reminding ourselves, no, it doesn't. So I am completely useless. Really melts away. It's like it's turning the heat up and melts away everything that is not just pure I am. I am completely useless. I have no function whatsoever. I'm completely useless. I have no function. Does perfect freedom have a function? No, God is not an architect assigning roles and functions to spirit. It's just spirit has absolute freedom. So I don't have any function. I don't have any function whatsoever. Of course, we understand that the one exception to this, it's not really an exception, is we have the function to encourage others to realize that they don't have any function. But that's a corrective, you know, helpful, encouraging function. We always understand that this out of compassion is in play, always. But we don't have to continuously state this in order to, quote-unquote, avoid level confusion. We're not in level confusion. We understand compassion. The grace of God is compassionate, and we encourage everyone to realize that we don't have any function whatsoever. So we can state that. I already know and accept that I don't have any function whatsoever. We're melting down the jewelry of the idol here. You know, claiming, oh, we have a very important function. You know, you need to do this and this and this and this. No, the only function you can say that I have is to reassure everyone else that they don't have any function. None of us has any function. No set function at all. Absolutely not. Reality is not some puzzle to be solved. We're not workers in reality. We're completely free spirits. So I don't have any function. I don't have any capacity. I don't have any ability whatsoever. I don't have any ability, no function, no capacity. And of course, we understand this as spiritual practice. This is not just ordinary, you know, talk. This is high spiritual practice in the context of compassion. I don't know anything. I can't do anything. There isn't any way. There's nothing I can do. Have any function. I don't have any wisdom. I don't have any wisdom. Right? What kind of wisdom can we have to accomplish the impossible? There's no wisdom involved with that. It cannot be. It's impossible. I don't have any wisdom. I'm empty. I have no wisdom. I am absolutely empty. There's nothing that I can do. There's nothing that I can do. There's nothing that I can rely upon. There's nothing that I can rely upon. There is nothing I can trust. There is nothing I can trust. Meaning, of course, any strategy at all that can succeed to convince arrogance is not arrogant. So there's nothing I can trust in this compassionate context. There is nothing I can trust. I cannot trust the ego in any way. In any way. There's nothing that I can trust. So embrace this as a positive, instead of continually trying to trust the ego. Say, no, there's nothing that I can trust. Nothing I can do. No way to succeed. Nothing to find. There is no way. I can't find anything. Nothing for me to find. I can't find anything. I cannot be anything. I cannot be anything. I cannot be successful. I absolutely cannot be successful. Now, if this is too difficult, don't worry. It is very difficult. But when you're ready for it, you will be able to do it. I cannot see it all. I can't see anything. I cannot see anything. I cannot know anything. I cannot do anything. I'm empty. You see, the I am doesn't need anything at all. And we melt everything else down, the I am will just is there. So we're just melting all the jewelry down of the idol, you know, and it's just an idol made of jewelry and ornamentation. Once it's all melted down, the I am stands self-revealed. We don't have to reveal it. It's self-revealed. We just have to melt down everything that is obscuring it. I have no value whatsoever. Nothing is valuable. I don't want anything. I don't have any value. Now the ego teaches us, don't ever say any of this stuff. The ego tells us this is absolutely forbidden. Absolutely forbidden to ever say what we're saying here. You can never say this. So just the saying of it is shocking because you're like breaking this ultimate taboo. Of course the ego doesn't want you to say this. It wants you to believe that you can. Yes, we can. That's the ego. Yes, we can is the ego. And it doesn't want to say, no, we can't. No, I can't. No, I can't. There's absolutely no way. I have no capacity whatsoever. None. The ego says, don't ever say that. This is absolute wickedness. Don't ever say that. From the ego standpoint, of course it is. Because it's the end of the ego. You know, end of this belief that we can do it. We can't do it. So, again, just the saying of any of these is shocking, because we're doing what we've been told. Not only us, but everybody here in this world has been told, don't ever, 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 ever even think about this anything like this. Don't ever say it. Don't ever practice it. If you do, you will surely die. You know, well, it's the ego that will die. It's projecting, right? It's saying that we'll die. No, it's the ego that will die. Well, we'll realize we don't need it. And don't even need it anymore. It won't really die. It just evaporates. no longer there. So almost 100% of everyone that comes to this world never ever practices like this. Never. They do not. They avoid it as if this were the plague. And they keep trying to affirm positive. Yes, I can. I can do this. I can. They say, no, I can't. It's impossible. I'm completely empty. I'm empty of all achievement. I'm empty of all success. Empty of all results. Empty of all resolve. I have no resolve. There's another one. I have no resolve whatsoever. I have no motivation. You see, again, the ego say, don't say that. You know, that's terrible. How can you say such a thing? And the ego wants to keep your motivation going to try and, you know, convince arrogance. It's not arrogant. But I say, no, I have no motivation. I have no motivation. I have no resolve. I have no will. I have no ability. I have no capacity. As we practice this, ultimately, I am, just I am, will be revealed, you know, sitting on the lotus throne, as they say, some say, you know, sitting, there's just I am. So I have no capacity whatsoever. I have no motivation. I have no ability. I have no willingness. I have no inclination. I have no achievements. I have no interest. Nothing to find, nothing to do. Nothing to see. And again, this is like breaking the ultimate taboo, which is why it's difficult for me to do this. I feel tired, because nobody practices like this in the world, really. We're told to never do this. This would be like the absolute curse upon us, you know. I have no life. I have no life. Of course, everything we're talking about, the context of life, as the ego sees it, I have no awareness. I have no consciousness. I have no consciousness whatsoever. I have no awareness. I have no life. I have no desire. I have no effort. I don't even try. I don't try at all. I can't even try. I can't even try. So again, I've never heard anyone suggest practicing this way, but it's absolutely taboo in this world. But it's probably given out in secret to, you know, to those who are ready. But again, it's completely taboo. I don't have any cares. I don't care at all. I do not care at all. If you come into the world, try to teach this way, you know, people say you're terrible, you're evil, you're wicked. But that's the ego that's talking and saying that. I don't have any way. I have no ways. I have no means. I have no abilities. I have no capacities. I'm void of everything. Completely void of everything. I'm completely empty. I can't do anything. I don't know anything. I do not know anything. I don't know anything. I don't want anything. I don't want anything. There's nothing that I want. I don't value anything. There's nothing that I value. I don't have any opportunity whatsoever. I don't have any opportunity whatsoever. So we continue to put on this blitzkrieg of effectiveness, because the world is really putting on a blitzkrieg of its own. That is for sure. These fanatics who are trying to tell us that there's a way. We know a way. Yes, we have a way. We're ready to convince arrogance that it's not arrogant. As soon as we do that, you know, millennium is here. That's why they call them the millennials. They believe that they have a way. So they're asserting, oh yes, I can do this. Oh yes, I can do this. I'm capable of doing this. And so we say, no, no, I can't do anything. There's nothing that I can do. I have no capacities whatsoever. But obviously, again, out of compassion, we have the capacity to practice, don't we? We have the capacity to realize we don't have any capacities. Capacities is an egoic concept. All the stuff we're practicing are merely egoic concepts. So I don't have any capacity whatsoever. have anything. I don't have anything whatsoever. Completely empty. I don't have anything. I have no values, no wants. Nothing to value, nothing to want, nothing to get, nothing to hope for. I have no hopes. I have no hope. I have no hope whatsoever. There we go. I have no hope. Now, it's quite amazing that, but I found that when I followed all the ego's boosterism, you know, that's what caused severe depression. And paradoxically, or interestingly, when we embrace the truth that I have no hope whatsoever, it doesn't cause depression. Just the opposite. We feel like, wow, this is great. There is no hope to ever do the impossible, is there? It's when we try to do the impossible that we subject ourselves to despair and depression. When we recognize the impossible as impossible, we can, no more, I don't need it. I don't need it, you know, and let go of all these concepts. I don't need any concepts. I don't need images, concepts, thoughts, bodies, worlds, universes. I don't need any of that. And we're just clearing away so the I Am presence can simply be experienced. The I Am presence, that's all. It's just a presence. The I Am presence can be experienced. I don't have any hope. I'm completely hopeless. I don't have a shred of hope. No talent whatsoever. No talent. All the talents we try to develop are, we think that this will help us convince arrogance is not arrogant. So it's impossible. So we can say, I don't have any talents. As a statement of liberation. I don't need to develop any talents like that. No. I don't have any talent whatsoever. No talent. No talent. No abilities. No capacities. No capabilities. No usefulness. No meaningfulness. I don't have any meaning. I don't have any usefulness. You can say, I'm completely worthless. I am absolutely completely worthless. Again, this is all practice. Okay, we're not trying to make absolute statements because the absolute doesn't need any statements. So if we're using words, that we're dealing with concepts, which means we are setting down the ego. Okay, so I'm saying I'm absolutely worthless. That means the objective of convincing arrogance is not arrogant is absolutely worthless. But the I Am presence has no objectives, needs no words, there's no concepts at all. So I am, yes, I am absolutely worthless. There's nothing that I can do. There's absolutely nothing that I can do. I can't do anything. I can't know anything. I simply do not know. I simply do not know. I have no options. I have no options at all. I have absolutely no options. And again, this is practice. Keep that in mind. So I say take refuge in practice, not in trying to think. It doesn't work that way. When we practice like this, we understand. Really, we get a feeling of what it's about. I don't have any options. Meaning, how can we have options in accomplishing the impossible? Are there options, ways to do it? No, there's no ways at all. So it can't be done at all, so there's no option. I don't have any options. It's not like, well, I can either do it or not do it. No, it's impossible. So there's no option there at all. So I don't have any options. Truth is not an option. It's all there is. I am is not some option. We say, well, I can either opt for I am or opt for something else. No, it's not possible. So say, I don't have any options. This is a very positive statement. These negatives are actually profound positives. Profound positives. I don't have any options. There's nothing that I can change. I can't change anything. I cannot change anything. There's nothing that I can change. I'm absolutely futile. There's nothing but total futility. There's nothing that I can change. So, we may have spent vast epochs avoiding saying any of this ever, but continuously thinking, yes, I can do it, yes, I can, I must find a way, you know. And so finally, we're saying the truth, you know, it's like, wow, this is great, but it's also stunning. Also stunning, yeah. That I don't have any options. There's nothing I can do, I have no options. Nothing to find. There isn't any way. There is no way whatsoever. Full stop on the wow when you're doing this practice. Just let it sink in. I have no options. I'm helpless. I'm hopeless and helpless. Completely hopeless, completely helpless. No capacities whatsoever. Nothing that I can do. Nothing that I can find. No options. I don't need a body. I don't need a world. I don't need anything. I don't have any needs at all. I don't want anything. I don't have any wants at all. I'm not a body. I'm free. I'm still spirit exactly as God created me. So have to keep pushing this forward, this practice forward. Because the opposition to this is getting ferocious, very ferocious, and we will really be in a situation where we will feel like we can't practice this way, can't do it. You know, we have to pursue the ego's objective, and it's futile. So you don't want to get trapped in that. You don't want to get trapped in futility, feeling like you must do it. So we have this great opportunity now. And we can practice by saying, I don't have any opportunity at all. I have no opportunities. I have no opportunity whatsoever. This is true, right? I don't have the opportunity to succeed in convincing arrogance that it's not arrogant. There's no opportunity there at all. I don't have any opportunity. I am is not an opportunity. It is reality. So it's conceptually, you say, I don't have any opportunity. I don't have any concepts. I'm incapable of conceptuality. There you go. I'm incapable of a conceptuality. I can't conceive of anything whatsoever. I simply cannot conceive. I cannot conceptualize. I'm incapable of conceptualization. There's nothing that I can do. I'm incapable of conceiving anything whatsoever. Okay, so how are we doing here? These practices are so intense. I don't want to keep them going too long here. An hour might be sufficient. I've tried the 2.5 hours, and that's great too. But an hour is probably sufficient for these very intense practices here. So, I feel great. I feel fine after this, yeah. It's like, wow. I feel like charged up. This is great. I love it. And we can say, I can never love. I can never love. I'll never know love. Meaning in the context, of course, of trying to convince arrogance to... That's not arrogant. Never happen. So I'll never know love in that context. I will never know love. There's nothing to love. I can't love. There's nothing to love. We can continue practicing that way. Whatever positive comes up, just see it in this context of practice. And I cannot conceptualize. So I'm incapable of conceptualization. Totally incapable of it. All right, let's go on and on and on, but I think an hour is sufficient here. So every time we practice like this, we've done a tremendous job, absolutely tremendous, staying ahead of the madness, outrunning the avalanche, that is for sure. So let's keep outrunning the avalanche here. Okay, very great. That's it for this one.